This video is based on Suffolk Royal Leaping algorithm that is proposed by Yusuf and Lenzi in 2003. They were trying to develop the network of pipes, and they used this algorithm to determine the optimum size of new pipes. This is a nature-inspired, swarm-based, metaheuristic optimization algorithm that is basically inspired by the frog's behavior in finding food in the wetlands. This algorithm is a combination of two algorithms, PSO and mimetic algorithm. The merits of these two algorithms are combined together. That's why this algorithm is simple, fast, and an efficient global optimizer. First step is population initialization phase. Here we will initialize the population randomly. As this algorithm is inspired by frogs, so we have the population of frogs, and each frog represents the solution or answer for the given problem, and the aim for each frog is to find out more food. And we can represent the position for each frog in the space using this. Here, xi means the position of the ith frog in the d-dimensional space. For example, we have 4 frogs, so the value for I is 1, 2, 4. x1 represents the position of first frog, x2 means position of second frog, and so on. Now you can see here we have d-dimensional space. So just imagine we have 3 dimension. So now you can see the final position for the first frog is this one, for the second frog, and so on. In step 2, calculate the fitness value for the each frog. And once you calculated the fitness value for the each frog, sort the population according to their fitness value. And we will place the best frog at the first rank. So just imagine we got the best value for the third frog. So we will place this frog at the first position, and so on. After that, divide the population into the subgroups. Just imagine we have here 2 subgroups, 1, 2. Now we will divide the population into these subgroups. As you can see here, we have the sorted population. Now we want to divide this population into these subgroups. Place the first frog in the first subgroup, second frog in the second subgroup, third frog again in the first subgroup, fourth frog in the second subgroup, and so on. So we will repeat this process until all frogs are assigned to the subgroups. So here we have just 2 frogs and population you can see here. After that, in step 4, we will select the best and the worst frog in each subgroup. So for the first subgroup, you can see the, just imagine the value for the third frog is this one, and this one is for the fourth frog. So we'll consider the minimum value as the best one. So just imagine the value for the fourth frog is here 0.1, and this is minimum. So we'll consider this the best frog, and the maximum value for the third frog is the worst frog. Same for the second subgroup, maximum value, first frog, worst one, and the minimum value is the best one. After that, we will perform the local search to optimize the position of the worst frogs. Now, as you can see here, in each subgroup, we have best and worst frogs. Now, we want to optimize, or we can see improve the values for the worst frogs. Now, we will perform the local search to optimize the position of the worst frog. You can see here, in each subgroup, we have worst frog. Now, in each subgroup, we will perform local search, and we will try to improve the position of the worst frogs. And we can perform the local search using this. Now just imagine for first subgroup, we have worst frog, this one, and we want to improve the position for this frog. Just for example, value for D can be calculated using this. Suppose any random value, 0.9. Best value is here, you can see 0.1, worst value is 2. And we got the value for D is this one. Now we will calculate the new position for the third frog. So worst value plus value for the D, and we got this one. So this is just for example. As you know, we have three-dimensional space, so we need another two solution. So this is just for the example. Now you can see we got the new value for the third frog. After that, we will calculate the new fitness value for the new position. And then in step 7, we will compare the older and the new solution. And during comparison, we will check whether the new value that we obtained is better than old or not. If the new value that you got is better, then we will replace the frog, else we will generate the frog position randomly. And we will repeat this loop until the number of iterations of local search is reached. Now in step 9, we will perform the global information exchange. Here we will mix all the frogs together. And in step 10, now we will rank the frogs according to their fitness value, and again place the best frog in the first rank, and then again in step 11, assign them to the different subgroups, and we will repeat this loop until the stopping criteria is matched. And once the stopping criteria is matched, we will display the best solution. See here, first we have population initialization. Initialize the population randomly, calculate the fitness values, sort the population, place the best one at the first rank, and accordingly divide the population into subgroups, select the best and the worst in each subgroup. After that, perform local search in each subgroup, and then calculate the new values and compare the new and older one, and replace the solution and generate the values randomly. After that, mix all the frogs, rank them, and then again assign them, and we'll repeat this loop again and again until the stopping criteria is matched. And in the end, once the stopping criteria is matched, display the best solution that you obtained in the previous iteration. So that's all about this video. If any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.